welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Question today from Jonathan, talking about data validation. We're talking about validation over the last couple of weeks. He said, you know, I have a situation where I have a list now, but the list may grow. Right now, there's 16 items in the list. But I want to allow room for more items to be typed at the bottom. And he was frustrated that when he set up validation, saying that the list could go from maybe A1 to A100, that it was screwing up the scroll bar. Basically, if you set up the validation with way too many cells and then open that, the scroll bar tended to show up down here at the bottom with nothing, and they had to scroll up all the time. That just wasn't a good solution. Well, there's a somewhat complicated way around this, and we're going to set up a named range. We'll go to Insert, Name, Define, and instead of just specifically typing a range, we're going to create a formula that points to a range, and we're going to use the offset function. The offset function takes 5 arguments. It says we want to start from one specific cell. So in this case, it's the lists worksheet, cell A1. I want to go down 0 rows and right 0 columns. Those are 2 arguments basically we're not going to use here, but I have to put zeros in. And then it wants to know how tall of a range we want to refer to. So I'm going to use the count A function and basically count how many entries are in column A of the lists worksheet. Now, of course, you can't have any blanks here or this won't work. And then finally, how many columns wide is it going to be? That would be 1 column wide. So I type all that in, click add, and I now have a name called a list. So I can set up validation now very easily, data validation. Allow a list, and the source is equal a list. Click OK, and you'll see that the dropdown now lists just the items in my list, and it doesn't go too far. The great thing is if I would come out of this list and type a new item, Z9999, and come back to the dropdown, it will automatically grow to get new items at the bottom of the list. So the whole trick there is that great little offset function, insert name define, that will allow the list to automatically grow. The other side benefit of setting up a named range is that you can now store all of your lists on a back worksheet. So for example, have all of your lists on the lists worksheet, and you can actually set up validation now on another worksheet, which generally is illegal. So we'll allow a list. Have it equal to a list. Click OK, and that works fine. You can even, of course, hide that back worksheet, format sheet hide, to prevent anyone from even seeing that it's there. So thanks to Jonathan for sending in that question, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.